and welcome to Goki India Steps Challenge Network 18 special campaign to encourage citizens to adopt a healthy lifestyle and embrace fitness by walking at least 6,000 steps a day for 100 days. India Steps Challenge has already gained momentum with celebrities and influencers coming out in support, and recently even Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore, Minister for Sports and Youth Affairs, has appealed to the nation to take on the challenge.
Khelo India was launched with great fanfare, and in no time it captured the imagination of the entire nation. It was an initiative that went a long way in reviving the sporting culture in India. Sports Minister Rajyavardhan Rathore went on to popularize Hum Fit to India Fit for a Fitter Nation. And social media was abuzz with pictures and videos of India taking the fitness regime seriously. India Steps Challenge is honored and proud to have the minister endorse and support the country to take 6,000 steps a day for 100 days.
A very positive challenge. It is India Steps Challenge. And India Steps Challenge is now open to all of you. A fit India will be a prosperous India. You have to walk 6,000 steps per day for 100 days. Aur hum sabko milkar, mummy, papa, uncle, auntie, dada, dadi, boys and girls, everyone together, take up this challenge. So India Steps Challenge is now open, aur ab chalega India.
Walking is not just about an individual effort. It can lead to a collective movement, helping the nation march to a healthier future.
Indeed, Ab Chalega India. But walking is not just an individual effort. It can also lead to a collective movement if done the right way. But in the fast-paced corporate life, young people often neglect health. So, we decided to bring you stories of organizations that support and actively encourage their employees to stay fit. First up is the story of Make My Trip, an online travel company which makes sure that going to work doesn't necessarily mean all work and no play.
Make My Trip is in its 19th year. The company actually started on April 1, 2000, where I had this idea that online travel could change the way people actually bought travel. The internet could change it. And it seemed like a fairly simplistic idea. It was obviously early for its time in India. It's fair to say that in our kind of job, the job is largely sedentary. So except people who are out on the field, most of the others are going to be sitting. Their job is on a desk. Their job is on a computer. Some of them spend very long hours actually working on the computer, staring at screens. And so you put a lot of pressure actually on your spine, particularly on the neck region. Over time, you start even slouching without realizing. So you have to very consciously remind yourself that you've got to sit straight and there's a posture. So most of the problems that are coming from sedentary jobs, sitting jobs, and postural issues. So we call them occupational hazards.
The lifestyle that we have is very stressful and it takes a toll on your health. So the food quality is not that good of what it used to be, let's say, 2 decades back. Junk food is ubiquitous. The air quality is not good. So being fit and having a focus on your health is a necessity that you should have.
I think for several years we've been very conscious of this. So the most important thing you can do is actually give the right advice and repeatedly in different ways. Make it interesting where people, the young especially, are willing to take in this advice and say, oh yeah, this is easy to do, and oh yeah, this can actually help me do this. So that's one thing, the most important thing. So we've got to therefore give them things that they can get relief and they're able to actually exercise a bit while at work. So whether it's yoga, whether it's Zumba, whether it's consultation with even doctors about lifestyle issues. We are encouraging people on, constantly HR will be telling them that, sitting is the new smoking and therefore one should be stepping out. There are groups that have been formed where people are trying to, I think, encourage each other to stay fit.
So as a company, it pays a lot of attention on body and mind both. So body-wise, they carry on a lot of sessions, be it yoga, Zumba, and they keep on sharing health tips time and again. On the other side, regarding the mind, They really keep on holding a lot of activities which can de-stress us and which will increase the efficiency of all the employees.
Scientifically proven that if you are fit, you have endorphins flowing through all out your body, and a happy employee is more cooperative, more productive, more understanding, has a better work-life balance. So having a fitness regime will always help you professionally.
I can tell you one thing with a lot of confidence, that our best performers, not surprisingly, are also fairly fit. The correlation is undeniable, but it's very hard to say how much, but undeniably you get better productivity.
One of the best thing about Make My Trip is it encourages work-life balance, and we have a flexibility of work timings and slots. And amongst all my friends, everybody has one or the other for sure physical exercise in their regime. And if their time slot does not fall as per the working hours, they make sure that they can flexible their time hours, and the company allows that.
Any fitness regime comes with a training curve. So some people can't take up gymming or weight training because they say it seems complicated. But walking is very imbibed into our DNA. It's a very basic exercise. And if you consult any fitness personnel, if you consult any doctor, if you consult anyone, walking is one of the best exercises that you can do.
It's a bit of a flywheel, and we've got to start it going. And if we start it going, I think there'll be a lot more people who say, hey, this is good. And then you're egging people on consciously and subconsciously. You see people walking in your condominium all the time, and I think you also feel like, hey, I should be doing the same.
Like certain things in life where you don't get results, fitness regime is something which will surely 100% give you certain results, and you may start noticing them in a week, in a month, but it will obviously help you in the long run.
Well, Make My Trip is definitely stepping up the benchmark for others to emulate. Now let's take a short break, but when we come back, there are more stories of corporate citizens who are taking the onus of good health of their employees. Welcome back to Goki India Steps Challenge. Up next is the story of Shiroz, an online community platform offering support, resources, opportunities and interactions exclusively for women. And at its helm, setting the trend for a healthy and fit workplace is its CEO, Sairi Chahal. Here's the story.
A lot of contributions that, you know, our lives have become very comfortable, we have too many creature comforts, we don't need to move as much, we don't need to exert as much, we have devices and machines and cars to do all our work. So in some ways we become lazy and we're not using our bodies to the best of their abilities. And of course there's tons of junk food out there, there's tons of stress out there, it all adds up. And I think it's really important to be conscious of this and of course invest in the right things for your health. Well, I think everyone needs to work on their health and fitness, and especially people who have very demanding sedentary jobs, which means that your brain is forever working but your body is not working so much. While it should be the reverse, because an active body and a calm mind is a good thing. It's really important to sort of put health on the map, and in some ways employers have a role in making that happen as well. So we actually as a company are pretty focused on health as a space. We have scheduled meditations on our Slack channel. We have actually comprehensive health cover for all employees to do proactive health checkups, not only for themselves but also for all their families. We have a resident physiotherapist who's available to our teams pretty much on demand, and people can sort of get physiotherapy sessions, you know, because they continue to work on their laptops all the time.
लोग कंप्यूटर पे काम करते हैं और जिससे कि उनकी नेक में स्ट्रेन पड़ता है, नेक स्टिफ हो जाती है और फिर प्रॉपर ब्लड सर्कुलेशन नहीं हो पाता, तो इसलिए नेक में पेन कंटिन्यू होने लगता है, जिससे कि यदि हम टाइम पे फिजियोथेरेपी का सेशन या ऐसा कुछ एक्सरसाइज वगैरह नहीं करते हैं तो सर्वाइकल स्पोंडोलाइटिस, रेडिकुलोपैथी, ऐसी प्रॉब्लम्स हो जाती है।
बेसिकली जो हमारी सेटिंग है, जो हम बैठ कर वर्क करते हैं, डेफिनेटली हमारे पोस्चर्स ठीक नहीं होते, क्योंकि लॉन्ग टाइम हमें अपने नेक को डाउन करके रखना होता है। मेरी कंटिन्यू 17 आवर्स वर्किंग हुआ करती थी। पूरे डे जो हम वर्क कर रहे हैं, माइंड जो हमारा कंसंट्रेट है, उसमें बहुत इश्यूज आते हैं। फिर क्या होता है, एक टाइम के बाद माइंड पूरा का पूरा डल हो जाता है, हम कुछ नहीं सोच पाते। हमारी कंपनीज हमारे अपने एम्प्लॉयज के लिए बहुत सोचती है, और हमारी कंपनी एम्प्लॉयज को वो सारे फ्रीडम हर तरीके से फिटनेस के लिए इम्प्रूव कराती है। इवन हम अपने ऑफिस में बैठ के खुद योगा सेशन भी होता है, मेडिटेशन होती है, हम सब बैठ के उसमें ईच एंड एवरी एम्प्लॉयज उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं। हम खुद फिट होंगे तो अच्छा काम करेंगे, अनफिट होंगे काम तो हो ही जाएगा पर वो लेवल नहीं आएगा।
We started doing the meditation sessions after She Rose as a company decided to put a larger focus on employee health, because we realized stress amounting to a lot more damage than we are okay with, right? So we started doing these sessions more or less 3 times a week, and these are meditation sessions. We follow something very specific called guided meditation, because we realized a lot of our work builds as physical stress in our bodies, especially in the nape of the neck, especially with a lot of wrist issues for most of the people who work here, because we are largely a technology platform. The reason we focus on mental health at the same, you know, with the same intensity as we focus on physical health is because a sound mind cannot, you know, exist without a sound body. So it's slightly, you know, it feeds into each other, it's codependent in a very healthy way, where you do need to work on your physical health at the same time as you're working on your mental health.
I rely on walks. Like, I take all my calls walking. Like, I never sit down at my desk and take phone calls, because that's a chance to move about and you sort of, it's a two-in-one. You will see a lot of people in the company in sneakers, because I do want to see everyone being active. You know, moving is the best thing you can do for yourself and for your body. Actually, I started walking because I started counting my steps. And I know tons of people who are very competitive about the number of steps they walk and how many calories they burn and how much water do they drink. If people walk more, then obviously they will be more conscious, they'll be happier, and they definitely be more healthier. And I hope everyone adopts Ab Chalega India.
Well, that was She Rose. Now our next story is of Adil Nargolwala, who heads the talent acquisition group at WNS Global Services. And with a job that requires him to be constantly on the move, he still manages to find that perfect balance in his life. While promoting a culture of fitness by organizing sports meets at WNS to his personal fitness journey as a seasoned marathon runner, Adil surely leaves no stone unturned when it comes to pushing the limits and setting new records.
My name is Adil Nargolwala. I work for WNS Global Services, large BPM organization. We are spread across the globe. I head talent acquisition for the company. Fitness is a way of life. It means a lot to me. It means being disciplined. It means dedicated to staying fit. It means sleeping on time, waking up on time, eating the right food, exercising regularly. Every day I either run, swim or bike. I go to the gym regularly. When I run, it's my me time. I'm with myself at that time. I'm not running for anyone but for myself. And it gives me a lot of time to introspect, to think. And overall, I believe that, it'll keep me healthy on my feet longer, and I'd rather collapse and die on my feet rather than linger on in a hospital bed or something and then finally, you know, meet my end. For me, discipline is very important. In anything you do in life, I believe that unless you have discipline, you'll never be able to do well in life. My day normally starts early in the morning. It would start either with a routine in the gym where my trainer will come in the morning and we put in about an hour, hour and a half in the gym. Or it would mean an external workout, which would mean either a cycle ride or a swim. So I'd go out and, you know, maybe bike 50 kilometers or so on weekdays. And on weekends, I'd either do a long run or I'd go and do a event, that means I'd take part in a marathon or something like that. Or I would go and do a long bike ride, which would mean maybe more than about 100 kilometers on the bike. Then I would be back home by about, say by 8:30, 9, beyond which I go to work. And once I'm in office the whole day, till evening. Once you get into the routine of, you know, exercising and routine of, you know, staying fit, then, you know, it just becomes a habit. So the runs became a habit, going to the gym became a habit. Automatically, you know, body changes started happening. I started losing weight. I started to, you know, getting more healthier. My endurance levels started to go up. My fitness levels started to get better. And, you know, from then there was no looking back. So I hold the Limca record for running the maximum runs in a calendar year, which is, you know, I ran 60 runs in 52 weeks. So, you know, that record stands even today. And then I ran the New York Marathon with my wife. We both ran that run together. And when we ran the New York Marathon, we realized that there is something which is beyond, you know, just running in India. And then we discovered the World Majors. And that's after New York, we went and ran. So after New York, I went and ran London. Then I went and ran Chicago, Germany, that is Berlin, Boston, Tokyo. So I did all the six majors. And once I finished that quest, I decided there must be something beyond this to do in running, and that's when I discovered that there's something even called the Seven Continents, Seven Marathons. And I went and ran in every continent, and recently I finished my last two continents, which was last month, when I ran the Antarctica White Continent Marathon as well as the Punta Arenas Chile Marathon. I ran my first run, it was a Bombay Half Marathon. This was the year 2009, January 2009, and I was very happy to run through a finishing line and get a medal at the end of it. I think that's where I got hooked onto the whole thing, you know. Totally, I would have run till now, I think, run nearly about 250 events. People are putting in long hours at work. Right? There's a lot of competition at work. There's a lot of competition at, you know, to excel. Right? And it's important for people. We should be smart about it. In our company, we promote health wellness. We take a very serious view of, you know, people being healthy at work, for which I lead this, you know, initiative, which is called WNS Sports. Last year, for example, over 9,000 people took part in any physical activity, which means either they ran a run or they played cricket, football, or any other, you know, game. This means literally one out of every four people in our company has participated in a sporting activity. We'd like our people to be fit. We'd like our people to, you know, stay healthy. We're very concerned about physical fitness of the organization. In fact, the sports engagement that we run in our company could be the largest employee engagement program that we have in our organization. Okay, so we ensure that all the activities that we do have equal participation. We don't want it only for serious sportsmen or serious players. We want everybody to take part in the sporting activities that we have. And if you're a fitter person, you'll work better. So your output will be better at workplace. So be it in your office or in your factories or whatever work you're doing. Because of your general fitness, you will have that much more energy and that much more better would you be at your work. Teams that play together will obviously work together.
Well, Adil's commitment to fitness surely inspires his entire workforce, and taking some inspiration from his story, I think we all should take this important step today to ensure a healthy tomorrow. So be a part of India Steps Challenge, 6,000 steps a day for 100 days. Share your fitness goals and achievements by using our hashtag UpChalegaIndia, and don't forget to tag your friends and invite them to participate, because who knows, you and your friends might walk away with prizes up to 5 crore rupees. So until next time, goodbye and good health.